anything going forward, even you, Mike, or the folks in your, sequester stuff, if you want to try to put together subcommittees to discuss some of these things, I like that idea of, operations, technical subcommittees. I think it gives the contractors an easier time instead of trying to communicate to the whole, especially the people we have in the varying levels of, participation. I think it makes their job easier and makes our job. Anybody got any thoughts on that? If you think about something, just send me an email if you got something that you, you know, Carol, if you think that some of the ag numbers need to be flushed out, I mean, that's what those guys are getting paid for. If you have questions.
Carol will probably have an idea about this one thing. If you want to.
I'm gonna call him. Yeah, I'm gonna get him up as soon as I leave.
Yeah, so this can be something as an open discussion. It sounds like we don't need to make that appointment right now as far as developing a technical subcommittee.
Yeah, it doesn't look like anybody's got, we do want to talk about the delegates.
Yeah, and what I was going to do to help facilitate that discussion is maybe throw up that very first map just so everybody can see your neighbor and councils. I thought that might be cool. I don't know how I went as far as assigning a delegate for each of their neighboring planning councils. And, you know, just to share kind of their process. Trying to get to that slide. You know, they just wanted to encourage intercouncil collaboration and be able to report back at council meetings from other council meetings. We have kind of a directive from EPD to try it, but in most cases, not to allow for council meetings to occur on the same day. This is actually. We have an exception today because Savannah Uprosing is going on, but we felt like that would be okay for Swans and Trails to have for the future. We would, for instance, probably never have Coastal Swans and Trails on the same day, obviously. We really wouldn't want to do that without them on
Flint.
Correct.
I would make the suggestion that some of you guys that are bad guys, we're all bad guys, Crop guys might want to attend that plan. The issues in the plan are, I mean, really, Cliff, you can comment on this, but they're probably the same issues we're all going to have at some point. They're just accelerated down there, right?
Absolutely. There's a lot. There's, you know, what you picture this region's potential, kind of worst case scenario, potential scenario in the future of limited supply and meeting demands. That's a reality for them now, and they have to take their species issues. So they have a lot of things going on there. So to them, there's nothing more important than this metering data and proven use and validated use and accuracy and acreage and all of that information we just talked about, and then how does that spread across the other sector. So, you know, we're in a really good position in this area. They are in. They're very interesting meeting, unfortunately. Lots going on.
The other one, to Mike's point from earlier, I mean, there's a reason they did that ASR test well in the Flint, because of this issue itself.
Yeah.
You know, being able to hear what they found and coming back and sharing that with the council, those kinds of things.
That's one of the reasons I'm bringing it up. I think it would benefit, especially the ag group, go to that meeting and hear what they're doing and why they're having to do it. I think it's a precursor to maybe hopefully more spread out of some of the things that we have to consider, and certainly not to the extreme that they are down there, but it would be better for us to be ahead of that curve and know what's working, what's not working, what's going to be points of contention and where it's going to come from. And all aspects of that. Rick, you like to.
Yeah, I just want to add something here. Again, we didn't want to throw so much at you today, so bear with us. So just, if you go back in your memory banks a little bit, right at the end of the planning process, you know, we've gotten resource assessments, we've gotten information on the gap information. The great thing about the way that the councils are set up is they're set up to what we're used to doing. They're they're set up by counties, because we like to administer things by counties. The environment doesn't follow county lines, so we're going to talk a little bit about this in a second, but remember the resource assessments then have to take the information that Cliff's done, and then we got to allocate that to watersheds and to aquifers. So in helping you just think about not just that, you know, why should we go over to Flint to know what their issues or their problems is, it's going to be very important that we use as much diplomacy and work together as teams now to think about the resource, not as the Suwannee Sotillo, not as the Flint, and not as the Altamaha, but it's as how do we as farmers understand how we're using the resource. So what we're going to be translating to as we get to the meeting in June is when you would overlay onto this the watershed, and I'll just be able to only kind of do it roughly, at that point, when you're looking at the watershed, you're looking how the watershed rolls up the planning nodes or the gauges. What we then capture is Chris County, Wilcox County, and our council in terms of that use. And the reason that's so important is, and this is where it gets diplomacy and patience is key, it can get into a finger-pointing deal, but for us to best understand, if we have a surface water gap, is surface water irrigation taking place in mostly Wilcox County, mostly Chris County, or mostly Suwannee Sotillo region? Not to point a finger, but to be able to say, hey, if we've got to do some practices that might help address shortfalls in surface water, we have to focus those management practices on the ones that are acceptable to the community in which they would be implemented. The most obvious way to say this is if we're dealing with a surface water gap for agriculture and we implement management practices for a municipal water provider, we're not going to do anything to address that. So the idea isn't for us to point fingers. I just really want to emphasize the importance for y'all not to just hear what's going on over there, but we got some really serious discussions that at the end of the process, if you remember, we just couldn't get there. We couldn't get there to say, again, I'll just use really loose language here, but is 80% of the use here, or is it here, or is it here? And then how do we then marry those management practices and spatially distribute them? So we need to build those partnerships, I guess, is the easiest way to say that.
I think some of those parents that we need to dive in. I'm glad you brought that up because this goes without saying, but I'm going to reiterate for the benefit of the group. When you're in Florida, they're not saying that the Flint region is a problem or that Suwannee Sotillo is not or is a problem. They're saying that South Georgia is a problem. And so it benefits us to understand what's being thrown at the Flint because whether you know it or not, it's being thrown at all of us. And really the state of Georgia. I mean, pretty much the people aside from the folks in on the inside just say, look, Georgia's a problem. So it's to our benefit to be able to speak. So with that being said, we don't necessarily have to set it up now, but if you're interested in getting involved in those meetings, I'd like for us to have a semi-structured approach to that. Delegates, if you want to just show up, that's fine too, but let's have folks that are willing to go and want to go.
You definitely know the lay of the land. Having folks like Ben kind of, and Darvin, who kind of, you know, they work right in that area, you know, where we had one of our last meetings at our Jimmy's barn, you know. We're over there, and you know, it felt like we were in the Flint Basin, but we were right at the edge of our basin, you know, or by the little river there, you know. And knowing kind of where those boundaries are, and kind of who's producing what, kind of what they're producing, the kind of proof of, because again, you remember, you go back to our plan, we took a first cut at it. I think we're the only council that maybe did that, where we actually tried, at least on an area basis, say about 8% or 10% of the X watershed and Y council contributes flow to this planning node, that really allowed us to kind of see some areas where, again, for example, on the Withlacoochee River, you know, Wilcox County is a pretty major, it's only a little sliver, but it's kind of a potentially major player right at the headwaters of the river that has a gap.
They also Mahal as well, you know, that's one source problem. Yep. It's coming out of there, so they are fortunate to get it.
One of them is litigation. Pardon me. Have you got anywhere close to the volume of litigation in Alabama, Florida, or that Flint, Chattahoochee still going on?
They are,
there's a mediator that's been mediator. So it's in some stage of mediation.
One of you just mentioned before I go to litigation, I just wanted to see anywhere close to the volume.
Well, the one thing on the technical subcommittee, they did give us kind of a homework assignment in the sense that EPA has asked for input from the council on the municipal, industrial, and energy forecast by April the 15th. Okay. I know just consuming that information today, we're still owing something on finalizing energy, which we'll get to pretty quickly. But I just wanted to mention that if we have some homework to get by, if there's a need to get into that information.
I'm speaking for myself right now, and I'm looking forward to discussion, but just looking at the data, it looks like there's not much to dig out of there. I mean, we did some pretty hard digging on it when it first came out. We kind of hashed out some of the issues that we thought were outliers, and it looks like it's been fairly consistent. That's a nice thing. It is a nice thing about how rich. Unfortunately, it's not growing, but it's also not changing. So, I mean, what do you guys think? Is there anything in there that we need to get together and hash out?
You know, again, nothing in particular. I think we owe you some action items we wrote on. The main one that I want to make sure we personally feel better about that could have implications is the, in terms of surface water resource assessment from wastewater pumps. Because we know we have some TM, some impaired segments here. We know from Dr. Lou's original work that there were some areas with lower dissolved oxygen. So I think that's an area. I don't think we need a technical subcommittee for it unless we find out something that we think we need to come over with you in more detail. But what we'll do is stay in communication with you on it. Like I said, and Shane, you jump in if you feel differently. In terms of the energy, we don't know the results yet, but I think from what I do know, there's a couple small biomass facilities that don't use any water. So there isn't really an energy-specific issue here. In terms of the water supply, it's all municipal uses are pretty much groundwater, and I don't anticipate major changes in groundwater modeling results.
I would like to quickly consider that surface water. That thing keeps popping up. And they're not, that thing hadn't been active. And the whole time we've got, we don't know what.
Yeah.
If it needs to be considered, it's fine to leave it in there, but if it's a permit and it hasn't been in that aspect the whole time this thing's been formed, we can't have it. So do we need to set up a technical subcommittee right now for y'all to communicate with if there is an issue, or do we want to just wait until there is one across our
I don't think we're either.
I'd rather wait. If we get to the April 15th, you guys haven't dug anything up, I think we're all fine with the information. The questions have been numerous, so I think we're fine.
But having said that, I do, to your original comments, Mr. Chairman, is I do see the value, and I do think that we should consider, we'll know it when we see it, and I just would give you all a heads up. My guess is things get a little more dicey, a little more complicated. There's a good chance that we may make a different decision for that. Maybe hopefully have more council members here to draw upon as well. And then, again, I'm just totally crystal balling, but if I were to say, would that make sense? I'm going to say 60% chance yes, and then the timing on that would be probably between June and September after we've got the resource assessments. Before we move into management practices, I think as council, we're going to really need to know, are we comfortable with the combination of forecast and resource effects before we can even start thinking about solutions? As council, we've got to really feel good about how those two things came together.
And another thought, too, that just occurred to me, with the next meeting being the council, a joint council meeting, we can do a good job to get those councils together. That might be a good time to work out the delegate.
Sounds good.
All right.
You are up again.
As you can see, I am also not this guy here. So, we have decided that Oregon had greener pastures for him. So, you get me again. Anyway, so it's still an important topic. If you remember, we did.